One of the most unusual objects in the universe are the neutron stars. Their densities are predicted to be over 100 quadrillion kilograms per cubic meter, whereas the Earth has a density of just 5,000 kilograms per cubic meter. This is because the entire mass of a star is compressed into an object the size of an asteroid. However, a recent finding might suggest that the Quark star, a new kind of star, actually exists. Despite the fact that the properties of a neutron star's superdense matter, such as its density and pressure, cannot currently be determined by scientists using their current knowledge of particle physics, a number of models for the neutron star's internal structure have been developed that are consistent with astronomical observations. Modern astrophysics states that stars with masses between 8 and 30 solar masses, or one solar mass equal to the mass of our Sun, end their evolutionary course with a supernova explosion, leaving behind a neutron star with a mass between 1.1 and 2.4 times that of our Sun. When a star runs out of fuel for the fusion reactions occurring at its core, it becomes unable to withstand gravity and suffers a catastrophic core collapse, which results in these explosions. As the pressure inside the core increases, atomic electrons are forced into protons and converted into neutrons, which results in a massive stream of neutrinos and gravitational waves. Up to a few percent of the speed of light is the velocity at which the outer layers of star stuff are expelled. Lighter stars, like the Sun, collapse into white dwarfs, which are also compact objects, but not as dense as neutron stars. Heavier stars eventually become black holes. Up until recently, all known neutron stars had masses that were consistent with theoretical predictions, falling between 1.2 and 2.3 solar masses. Scientists reported the discovery of a neutron star with a mass considerably below the predicted lower limit in a recent study that was published in Nature Astronomy. HESS J1731-347 is the name of the supernova remnant in which this peculiar neutron star resides. This object, which is roughly 8,150 light years away from Earth, is made up of the debris from the explosion and the interstellar material that the shock wave propagates through. Researchers established the neutron star's radius, mass, and thermal emission spectra by analyzing observational data of the remnant obtained by the Astrometric Gaia Space Observatory and the Newton X-ray Space Telescope. It turns out that an object of this type typically has a radius of about 10.4 kilometers and a surface temperature of about 2 million degrees Celsius. However, the fact that it has a mass that is only 77% that of our Sun perplexed astronomers because it is almost 1.5 times less than the theoretical lower limit. The astrophysicists put forth two hypotheses to explain why the measured value of a neutron star's mass differed from what was predicted theoretically. The first of these is that the known characteristics of stuff within a neutron star may not be as fixed as previously believed. These characteristics challenge some of the accepted theories on the structure of neutron stars while supporting others. The second hypothesis is that the observed object is a quark star rather than a neutron star. Soviet scientists Dmitry Ivanenko and Dmitry Kerjelades originally proposed the idea of the existence of such objects in 1965. The theory predicts that neutrons are so compressed at high pressures in the collapsing cores of stars that they disintegrate into the constituent fundamental particles known as quarks. Quarks clump together, even though they are free, to create a quark star as a result of the strong interaction and tremendous gravity. There are six different types of quarks in nature, which are categorized as up, down, strange, charmed, bottom, and top in order of increasing mass. The so-called strongly interacting particles known as hadrons, of which protons and neutrons are the most well-known, are made up of all of these constituent particles, with the exception of the top quark, which is too fleeting. Despite the fact that up and down quarks make up neutrons, it is thought that their heavier counterparts can potentially develop in a quark star. This may be because under the extreme pressures and temperatures at the centers of these fictitious quark stars, strange quarks are formed as a result of the interaction between released up and down quarks, earning these stars the moniker strange stars. If weird stars are actually possible and the object found in the current investigation proves to be one of them, the discrepancy between theory and observations will no longer exist because the minimum mass limit described above only applies to neutron stars, not quark stars. The existence of unusual stars and the results of this study will hopefully be supported by other astronomical observations in the future. In addition to being an amazing new discovery in and of itself, this would provide researchers a better understanding of the very nature and behavior of quarks, which we are only now beginning to comprehend.